Hey guys, it is me, Elvis Freshly, and I am back with a review of MyTouch 4G. And it's not just any MyTouch 4G. Let me see if I can prop this cam up just a little bit better. I'm trying to get it so you guys can get a really good view. Okay. It's gonna rock. This sucks. Okay. You know, say you should get this straight before then, but you guys know how I operate, so oh well. Okay, so what I'm going to be showing you is the MyTouch 4G with Gingerbread. So let's go ahead and start. As you can see, this is stock, and there's not going to be much difference. Now, this was optimized for root. If you guys don't know what root is, that is gaining administrative privileges, things you should not be toying with if you're not familiar with Android development. I would not suggest this. So for you viewers and commenters out there, please don't ask me how to do it. Do the research, figure it out yourself, or visit XDA developers. This particular version was done by Fox123 or Fo123. I don't really know what it is, but I think it's Fox, just Faux, but I know that can be said Fo. But anyway, we're gonna say Fox123, and he did this and he optimized it as soon as the leak came from 911 sniper over in China. Okay, so let's dig into this a little bit. So as you can see, in theory, this is my sense. Let's get right into this right here. Let's go to settings, and we're going to knock this out in the beginning. I'm going to go down to about phone, and let's go down here to software version. So as you can see, this is definitely Android 2.3.3. This is running HTC Sense, the MySense version, which is only available on the MyTouch line, which is the MyTouch Slide, and which will be the double shot, the MyTouch Slide 4G, MyTouch Slide, basically MyTouch 4G. So HTC and T-Mobile have come up with this watered down version of Sense. It's still Sense. Meaning, as you can see, I have Peep up here, things like that, but we'll get into that in a few. Okay, let's back out of here. As you can see, they actually added software updates in here. They usually don't do this. They actually have another thing called Tell HTC. A lot of people have been reviewing saying there's only one change. No, there's not. There are tons of changes in here. So you have Tell HTC, which is, in theory, a bug reporting thing where you can make it where it reports directly to HTC. You can automatically send error reports or ask me each time before sending. I have my automatically sending them. Network preference, you can change that. And you have to enable this. Now, another big thing is, as you can see, look at that. Hold on. Let me get right there so I can do it for you. You see that symbol? It says 4G, no more HE. 3G. It's just strictly 2G instead of E. 3G and 4G. Now, this is the shocker. As you can see, it says 4G now, but as you can see, I'm on UMTS, which is 3G. You're lying to me. So, you know, hey, you know, to each his own, but hey, let's keep going. Another huge thing is this. Instead of, I don't use the power widget anymore because in the drop down bar, you see this is the regular notification bar, you have what's called quick settings. So instead of using the power notification widget now, you have it right here and it's convenient. You can control your Wi-Fi, your Bluetooth, your Wi-Fi hotspot, your GPS, your mobile network, or you can just go to all settings and now you're in your regular settings menu. Nothing else has changed here in the regular settings menu. Everything is the same as far as personalizing and everything. Now, something that has changed, I really wish I could, let me see if I can do it. I'm not sure. This is primarily the same, as you can see. It's you know, that hasn't changed at all. But when you're calling someone now, you have a, let me see what I can do. Let me see if I can call. Let's call my Google Voice. 1 second. I'm going to call my Google Voice so you guys can see this. Can I call it? 347. Okay, let's try this. Okay, hold on 1 second, guys. Hold on, I don't know my Google Voice number. Hold on, guys. Let's get this together. Give me 1 sec. Okay, screw that. Okay. In theory, your call screen is going to be different. What's going to happen is when you're calling someone, you're going to get a... Trying to say, no, it doesn't show up for some weird reason. It's not showing up. I guess all my contacts haven't synced yet. Battery life on here, it's good. I mean, a lot of people in the forums have been complaining. Why? I don't know. It comes with the normal, usual crapware, of course, as you can see. You know, Rock Band, but you know, when you're rooted, you can delete all this stuff. So it's moved over to the system. It's moved out of the system partition, and I'm running this on extension 4. For those of you guys who don't understand extension 4, it's too much to explain in a YouTube video. Asphalt's in here. Let's go back. Let's see what else is different. I'm really trying to show you guys the huge differences. There are a lot. They made some browser changes. In this one, I actually have Google Talk with voice. And as you can see, I mean, with video. No one has it though, unfortunately, in here. Yeah, no one has it, so that kind of sucks. So it's not like I can really use it, but in theory the camera is the same. As you can see, it's the same camera. They didn't change that, but you know, this is Gingerbread. Quick does work with here. Finally, Quick is optimized for this. I've been working with Quick developers, getting some different versions out there. I have a couple of them that I've been beta testing for Quick, so the video does work now for the Gingerbread ROMs. Let's see. I really don't know, because there are some things that are different, and I was playing with it earlier, and there's a lot more that's changed. I'm just like really kind of deadlocked right now. I just wanted to get this video out the way and show you guys that it is here and it has arrived. But in theory, there's not too big a difference, I'll be honest. But like I say, the call screen is totally different. I really want to call someone. Let me see if I can call someone. And who can I wake up at 1:40 a.m. without getting cursed out? Let's see. Okay. Okay, I'll call. Doing this call right here, as you can see, the drop down thing is right there. So you can see? That's basically the drop down thing was moved to the top now on the new ones. Let's try to call voicemail. Let's see. So, I mean, that looks the same, but when there's a social network merged with it, it'll be right there now. That's another thing that's changed. As far as, let's see, themes are all the exact, like I say, seriously, as far as those aspects of it, they're the same. Your My Zones, everything is the same. Wallpapers. I think there are some new ones. If I'm correct, there are some new ones. Let me... Oh, yeah, there's a new live wallpaper. That is right. So you see we have the galaxy, the grass, the maps, the Nexus one. Follow. Slideshow, spectrum, VU meter, water, waveform. One of these is new. I'm not sure. They were talking about it earlier. Yeah. Let's see. Favorites is pretty much there. Gmail. It is the 2.3 Gingerbread Gmail. I'm not going to go into it because it'll show all my messages. And I don't need any more smart-ass comments. Pretty much. I mean, honestly, that this is it. So, I mean, there were a lot of underlying changes. But the overall ROM itself has stayed the same. And, you know, as I can say, I didn't really want to get into speed tests and all that on this because I feel it's unnecessary. pretty much that's it, guys. I want to thank you guys for tuning in. Make sure you click subscribe to Super Elvis Freshly ATT, and you guys keep up with me, and I'll keep you guys up every time I come up with something else nifty or handy to review. All right, guys. Thanks. Have a good one. Bye.